So, hi guys. If you want to know how to get this creepy look, because it is really kind of creepy, watch my video. Finish watching it, you know? Because it's the only way you're ever gonna find out. So watch it. I like it. Have some fun. Because this was actually really fun to do. So I hope you guys all enjoy it, and we will start. I'm totally gonna start wearing my hair like this, just saying. Well, anyways, let's get started, because who knows how long this will take. And I already did my foundation, because you guys have seen me do my foundation like a million and one times, and I feel like I know how I do it. Anyways, oops, there's stuff on my paper towel. My paper plate, I can't speak. Alright, so for this tutorial, I was gonna tell you like all the like products you're gonna need ahead of time, but I'm gonna be honest with you. I don't really know exactly what I'm doing yet, so we're just gonna like find out products as we go along. Anyways, you're gonna need like non-toxic glue. I went to Dollar General today because I tried to film this video before, and I went and got liquid glue from my sister, and she told me where it was and everything. I went and grabbed it. I start filming the video. I already put all my makeup on and everything. I go like this. Nothing's coming out. I was like, what the heck? Like, maybe, you know, it's just all at the bottom. So I shake it a few more times. I mean, this is still, like, recording, and I'm just like, oh my gosh. So I take the lid off. I go like this. It's all in there. Like, the full entire tube. Like, all of it's in there. Dried out. I was like, what the heck? Like, how am I supposed to film my video? Sorry, I had an itch. I was not picking my nose, I swear. I was like, how in the world am I supposed to film a video when I don't have my glue? So I went to Dollar General to go get glue today. I was going to get Elmer's glue, but I could get a bottle this big for a dollar, or I could get two bottles of the knockoff Elmer's glue for a dollar. Dude, you can see my roots growing in. I really need to dye my hair, because you can tell it's like red, 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 black. Well, actually, it's red, 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 green, awkward colors, black. So anyways, I got this thing. This is like the knockoff of Elmer's glue. The main thing is to make sure that it is non-toxic. That is like the only thing that I'm really worried about right now. Non-freaking toxic. Alright, and then you need a paper plate. Or something to put it on. I'm putting mine on a paper plate. Let's hope it's not dried out. I was thinking about that on the way home. I was like, what if it's dried out? Oh my gosh, it's not coming out. It's dried out. Why isn't it coming out? Is there a thing on this that stops it from coming out? It has this thing on it. I didn't know glue put that. What is this? Why can't I get this off? Dang it! Got on my computer. This thing was in it. It's like a little cork. That's weird. I don't like that. Oh, and you're gonna need toilet paper. I forgot to mention that. Toilet paper. Lots of toilet paper. Let me clean this up. I don't want it to dry. Alright. Put the lid back on it. Now it should work. Yay! Glue! Alright. So, to start off, I'm only putting, like, that much. I don't know if you can see it. It's right there. It's moving. Ah! I'm only putting like that much to start off. And honestly, I don't know where this is gonna go, but I guess we'll find out. So, take some toilet paper. Probably didn't need to grab that much. I think this is 2-ply, so I'm gonna rip it into 1-ply. And my fan is making everything move around. And so, I guess I'll tear it as I go because my fan's making everything move. And I'm just gonna use my finger because I don't wanna use my finger. But I don't want to dirty any of my makeup brushes. Okay, so we're using my finger. And I'm just going to go like this. And I'm going to put it right here because I'm going to make my cheek all weird. I don't know what I'm going to do. Don't ask because I don't know. And you take little pieces, stick it there. A little way than that. Oop, oop, that was probably too little. Oh, bad idea. I should be using a brush, but I'm not. Oh, it kind of dried, so now I need more. Oops. I hope that sticks. Probably not, because I didn't put glue over here. This is gonna be a long tutorial in case anyone cares. But hey, it's Halloween. It deserves a long tutorial. Am I right? Yes, Kirsten, you're right. Oh, good. Hey, I'm right. For once. Just kidding. I'm always right. I'm gonna make this little patch a little bit bigger. Just so I have more room to work with. You know what I mean? You never know how much space you're really gonna need. It's a big piece. If you guys can see my face. I'm gonna do other pieces too, so don't worry. Like in other places. I don't have any glue right there, really. I make weird noises, get over it. If you can't handle my weird noises, then get out! Just kidding. Don't leave me. Don't leave me! Okay. Okay, I've learned. Tear, glue, then place. I was trying to glue, tear, place, everything all at once. Well, not all at once, but you know what I mean. That piece isn't gonna stick yet. Alright, alright, alright! Yes, I'd Matthew McConaughey get over it. Mm-hmm. Just kidding. Stupid fan. I should've turned the fan off. It's too late now. I'm already started. Glue right there. In place. This is not that hard. Just so everyone knows. So if you're sitting there going, this is gonna be a hard makeup tutorial, this is like the easiest thing in the world. This is easier than my actual makeup tutorial. So get over yourself. I don't know who would be saying it, but you know. Ah! Tear. Tear again, because that was too big. Come down on the cheek a little tiny bit. More glue, because that did not work. I should have grabbed a rag. I have nothing to wipe my finger off on. Oh, that dries kind of quick. But not quick enough. Okay, that honestly, when I say not quick enough, I mean seriously, it doesn't dry quick enough. So we're gonna use this magical little thing on the cool setting because I don't wanna use the hot setting. I'm gonna unplug this. This has enough battery, hopefully, I hope. Try! Maybe not on the cool setting. I just move it around a lot. Dude, that's working! On the cool setting, it hurts. Ooh, the cool thing. You know when you have like minty gum and why did this fall down? I have a one-track mind sometimes. Okay, you know whenever you have like minty gum and you have like drink cold water afterwards and it gives you like that feeling in your throat? Putting glue on your face and using the cold setting of a hairdryer gives you that same feeling on your face. And I think that's dry enough to put another layer. And no, I was not anticipating using a blow dryer. I just happen to have a blow dryer here in my room. I'm being serious. This is my makeup table. I have everything you would ever need to do beauty stuff. So I guess I could call it my beauty table. I didn't realize the piece was that big. I just splattered glue everywhere. Where did that go? I know it splattered. I saw it fall, but I don't know where it fell. I should be using a brush because I feel like I'm moving all this around and it's not staying. It's just moving everything else. Guys, this does not need to be like perfect because what Halloween look is perfect. What's the point in having a perfect Halloween costume? Everyone compliments it. Just kidding. And honestly, like with the toilet paper, because if you can see, I'm struggling. You can tear it up beforehand, which is what I should have done. But like I said, my fan is on, and it's gonna just move it around, and it's like a total waste. This is gonna be a while. So in a minute, I'm probably gonna go off camera and just finish this, so you guys don't have to watch all of it, because now I'm just gonna keep layering it. Okay, which is pretty much what I'm gonna do. Okay, so we know how to put it on. And so pretty much all you're gonna do is layer it, you know, glue, toilet paper, dry. Glue, toilet paper, dry, until you have the desired look, texture, whatever that you want. All right, and then, okay, so actually what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna do it in the other places really quick, just so you guys can see like roughly what I'm gonna be doing. And then I'll go and I'll layer everything up. That way you guys don't have to watch the whole entire process, because this could get pretty boring pretty fast. If you know what I mean. And right now, I know it does not look like what you're expecting, but bear with me. I know you guys weren't expecting to put toilet paper all over your face, but bear with me. This takes time and effort, things I don't have in life. Okay, should we put one on our nose? Yes, yes we should. What type of question is that, Kirsten? Of course you should put one on your nose. Maybe it'll get caught in your nose ring and rip it out like your foundation did. My foundation ripped out my nose ring. My sponge did. It was the sponge's fault, not mine, I swear. The sponge did it. Just like guns. Guns do it. Just rip that little piece off, because that's not gonna work. Oh, I can see it in my eye! It looks weird. Toilet paper stuck to my finger. The nose should be the easiest one, because there's not much to do. Just a little tiny bit. I'm not going to do my forehead, because my hair just kind of falls over my forehead anyways. But, you know, maybe I'll do a little bit, like, right here. Since I could do it going through my eyebrow, but I don't want to put glue on my eyebrow. That sounds like the biggest mistake in the world. I think that would, like, end up on, like, something weird where I don't want to be at. Girl rips off her eyebrow with Elmer's glue. Oh, can do internet sensation. Maybe I should do it. Just kidding. Alright, so now what you're gonna do is just layer them. I'm gonna go do that right now, and I will be right back. Maybe. Oops. I'm gonna try to turn this off. Okay, so that's all done, and I realize it's really hard to move my mouth, so if I look really stupid talking, it's because of this one. If I move, it's gonna rip it. Hopefully, after I mess with it, it's gonna be easier. Okay, also, I went ahead and already did my foundation on top of it, so pretty much this looks super, super easy. All you do is take a concealer. Well, after it's all dry, make sure it's dry. After it's dry, I took a concealer, put it all on it. Then I took my foundation that I normally just use, which is Wet n Wild Ultimate Match in the color Ivory, which is this, and I put it on top. And then I took my loose powder, which is my... I don't even know what this is. I think it's CoverGirl. Dude, I don't even... Oh yeah, it's CoverGirl, because the sponge thingy says CoverGirl. powder thing, not sponge. You know what I mean. Okay, so then I put that on top of it, and now we're at this point where I have to decide what we're gonna do. So I'm gonna take a bobby pin. I know this sounds weird. Take a bobby pin, and I'm gonna start with this one. And I'm gonna, actually, I lied. I'm gonna take a pair of scissors. And I'm gonna just carefully cut open somehow. By like pinching it and then, don't tear it off. I need my littler scissors. Do I have tweezers with me? No? Okay. Bobby pin it is. There you go. So take the bobby pin and kind of just carefully rip this. I lied. I'm gonna go grab my little scissors. I know where they're at. I hope. Okay, these are my little scissors. Like cuticle scissors. Alright. So we're gonna take these, carefully cut it. See how much easier that works. Don't go all the way to the top and don't go all the way to the bottom. Trust me. And be super, super careful. And then you kind of just want to... We'll do that in a second. Okay. Be so, so careful not to actually cut yourself, please. But I mean, if you do, then... I guess you could stop there. How'd you get that look? Oh, I cut myself with scissors. How'd you manage that? I was trying to get this look. I almost just cut myself. This one's falling off. Bye bye, nose piece. That one didn't stay. I knew it wasn't going to. I could tell when I was drying it because it was like being super stupid. This one, you could cut like this. This will be fun. Alright, and then I'll cut this one like... That's fun. Really all we're doing is just kinda making it look like we have little cuts that kinda went on. This one should be fun. This one kind of already has a little piece that's sticking up. Makes it easier. Sorry. I'm trying to like hold the rest of it down so it doesn't accidentally lift. Because that's like my biggest nightmare. It's just gonna lift when I'm trying to make this one like a big gash. Yeah, look at that gash. Getting glue all over my scissors. Alright. So I kind of made this gash and I kind of made it like go down and around. Alright. So then you're going to play with it and kind of get these little ends to kind of like stick up. Maybe cut them a little bit, you know, because your skin wouldn't cut perfectly. Make them look really gross. Clean the glue off if you need to. Make these look really nasty. Like that. Told you it was gonna lift. That one's not gonna really do much without breaking off, but this one, I think I did a good enough job on this one that I can mess with it a little bit. And all I'm doing is really just taking it and cutting down onto it. So it makes it look kind of razored. You can see that. Let me try to get closer. Oh, I can't see now. Okay. See? Just kind of making it look all gross. You can tear it if it's easier for you just to tear it like that. See, take this whole little chunk off, tear it. Whatever gets it to just work for you. Alright, and then I'm gonna kind of flap that. Alright, and then I have a couple little lipsticks that I'm gonna be working with, but let me grab this. So, pretty much you're just gonna wanna take some like red lipsticks. I'm starting with like a dark one. Just get it all in there. And you want to get this on the little flaps, so they don't look like they're white, because your under skin is not gonna be white. And try to get it like into the little grooves that you accidentally made from it lifting a little bit, and pray that it doesn't finish lifting before this tutorial is over. When you get it on the flaps, it's okay to kind of mess up and get it onto like the skin underneath, because we're gonna end up putting some there anyways. So don't like freak out and try to make it perfect. And if you have fake blood, you could probably totally use that too. But unfortunately, I haven't really gone Halloween shopping yet, so I don't have fake blood yet. See, that already looks so much better. Sorry, I had to readjust. I'm gonna take some more and layer that inside though. Just because I feel like it needs to be darker. I mean, like I said, I'm gonna be working with a couple different lipsticks, so it'll look even better. And then do the same thing on this one. I'm dragging this one up to my lip though, because I want it to look like I got cut from my lip. Same with these two. This one goes all the way across. It did. Guess it laid back down. Ah! That's funny. Dang, this is looking good so far, guys. Alright, and then you're gonna do the same thing to this one. This one we're being careful with because I messed it up. As we all saw. We don't want to mess it up even more. Even though I'm probably gonna leave this little flap down, I'm still coloring it in under it. Just in case if it does decide that it wants to cooperate. If you know what I mean. So there's that. So now we're gonna take, hopefully my darker one. Yeah, this is like a dark purpley color. We're just gonna kind of take some off the top of that. It's like a purpley red. So we're gonna kind of put that into the, like, the middle, hopefully, maybe not. Kind of splatter it onto these. This blood has, like, not texture, but different colors in it. Contrast, I guess is the word. I don't know the word I would use. This is kind of like another dark red, but it's like a different one. Oh, what I'm doing over here is just wiping the color off so it's easier to get the new color. In case any of you guys were wondering. Same thing, we're kind of just splattering it up into this. All over. All right. And then where did it go? Oh, there it is. We're gonna do some gel eyeliner, but we're gonna do this weird because I don't want to get my lipstick into there. And I don't want to get lipstick on my gel eyeliner pencil. So I'm gonna take some up with the back of my pencil. Maybe not pencil, brush. Put it along here and blend it in. If that made sense to you. We're kind of just putting that along, like, the edges where the skin flaps meet, just to give it, like, more depth, if that makes sense. And we're going to blend that in just a second, don't worry. I'm going to try to do the same thing on the other one, but it might just look really stupid. Oh, no, that looks good. Guys, look at that. Yeah, boy. This one looks weird because it's, like, a shadow. Alright, so now we're gonna kind of just blend that in, but I'm gonna put what I didn't use back, close that so it doesn't dry out. I hope you guys can hear me because I can't talk, but hold on. Need to wipe off the back of this so I don't accidentally get black all over my hands. Clean off this so I can blend. Blending is fun. Okay, so we're just gonna blend that out a lot. Because we want it to look like it blends in. We don't want it to look like we just put black there. Even though that's what we did. Let's go ahead and bring it into it. And then I'm also going to kind of clean that off again. And I'm going to take the original color that we started with. Because I really, really like the way this turned out with this color. I'll kind of put some more into, like, the middle area and blend that out. See, that gives it, like, a ugh look. How come no one told me there was still white right there? Guys, I thought we were friends. You're supposed to tell me this stuff. Okay. Fun part. Now we get to actually deal with the skin. So I'm gonna take just like a little bit not a lot of this color, and just kind of, and then blend it out. I should just put it onto my finger and do that. I got too much. Because like I said, you're going to get color on it anyways, because when you bleed, girl, you're going to bleed. And you're going to blend it onto your actual skin too, like not just... And this makes it look irritated and bloody. So there's like that one, there's those ones, there's that one, which I'm really proud of this one so far. And even though, like, I didn't get that thing to stay on my nose, I'm still gonna, like, make it look kind of bloody. Irritated. Because your face would be irritated. I'm also gonna do some, like, around my eyes, but I'm gonna finish the other makeup first, which involves this palette that I forgot to grab. Alright. Where's that other brush? No! Brush has gone wild! They're missing! Oh, there it is. Alright. So, I'm gonna take, like, a brown color and put it underneath my eyes. As if, like, I was putting dark circles under my eyes, which is what I'm doing. And then I'm also gonna take this brush, same color, and put it like into like the crease of my eye and blend that around and bring it to connect like a circle. It gives it that creepy, irritated look, I guess is what you could say. It gives you like that I'm dying look, but I'm not dead yet. I'm dying, but I'm not dead. I guess is the way you could say it. You just kind of blend that around. This side got darker than the other side. So you kind of just do that with your eyes. Okay. I'm going to take just like a tiny tad darker and put that into like the crease. Like directly into the crease. Just to give it more depth. I'm going to do that on the bottom crease too, but I'm going to do it the other crease first, just to make it match. Like I said, this look involves a lot, and a lot, and a lot of blending. And you're probably going to have to go back and forth between colors, because they will get messed up. And yes, there is a bottom crease, in case anyone was wondering. I'm not just crazy, there really is a bottom crease. And you're gonna put it right into that bottom crease and mix it around. Blend it around. I can't talk. Alright. And then you're just gonna take that original color again, because sometimes, you know, you need just a little bit more. And then also, we're gonna take like this nasty yellow color that I have. I don't like yellow, so every color is nasty yellow, and put it like right along the edges, because it's gonna give it that really like irritated, bruisey look. Because I'm pretty sure if you got cut up this bad, you were probably punched in the face a couple of times too. I put it on the top as well. That one you might want to blend out with your finger because it's a little easier. Itch. Alright. And then also just a tad bit of like a dark purple. Just like in like the center area. Like in between the two colors. just to give it that more bruisey effect. If you know what I mean. And then you're gonna take your other brush, blend that out a little bit. I got glue on my eye. It's probably left over from that nose one. Okay. And then we're gonna take like that nasty yellow color again and put it around like our nose. Yes, even though we already put the lipstick, we're still gonna irritate our nose a little bit more. Cause like I said, you probably got punched a couple times. And then take that purple color again. And just like right in the creases of your nose, you're gonna put that purple color. Because that's right where the purple would be at. And then you're gonna blend that all in. Looks good so far, right? All right, so I'm gonna take that brown color again. And we're gonna kind of dab that right along the edges. Oopsies, that was a little bit too dark. So don't take a lot at the time. I kind of took a lot, just kind of barely touched the palette. Because otherwise it's gonna not blend very well. Move flaps. Stupid skin flaps in my way. Never thought you'd hear me say that, huh? You know. Since I'm living. Well, I'm alive, so you know. Close enough, right? I feel like I'm like looking like I'm down in this video, like upset, but I'm not. I just can't speak because this thing on my mouth. So don't mind me, I'm not upset. I literally like I'm trying so hard not to move my mouth that much because I don't want to break thing before the tutorial's over. Okay, so then we're gonna take that nasty yellow color again and kind of just dust that on there as well. Guys, I'm so glad I figured out what I was gonna do. Because when I said I didn't know what I was going to do, I wasn't kidding. I literally did not know what I was going to do. I just kind of went with it. And try your hardest not to like rub it too much because you don't want to lift the stuff. Okay, same thing with the purple. I can't even blow. Oh my gosh, my phone just buzzed and it scared the crap out of me. I don't know if you guys saw me jump, but I totally just jumped. This looks really good from like far away. Yeah, buddy. Come on for your girl. Mr. Still your girl. I got it. Alright, and then again, oh, my lipstick fell. We're gonna take that original lipstick again. And kinda just, I go like this to get it so it's not so dark. And then just kinda dab it again. Make everything look a little bit more irritated. Put it around the nose again. probably a little bit on. Go like this. Put it onto your lips and then kind of. Let me make my lips like dried out. Hold on. You can do like a cut in your eyebrow. Actually, we can. Where's my little thing? Just kind of go like that. Then I could go up out of my eyebrow so it doesn't look like I just messed up on my eyebrow. There we go. Look at that. Look at that. Oh, yas. 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 I can still do one on my nose. Yas. I'm still gonna blend that out around there. Make it look more irritated. I just dropped my lipstick on the ground and it's open! That's no fun. Oh no, it got hair all over it. I'm so sad now. This is like one of my favorite lipsticks, and I totally just ruined it for this video. And I just realized I still have glue all over my fingernail. Watch this. Oh, you missed, Armand. I didn't do it in time. Alright, let's irritate my nose, and then we'll put more stuff on it. Dude, this is looking so good. I'm so proud of myself. I didn't think this was really going to turn out that great, but it did. I'm just kidding. I knew it was going to be great. All right. Now let me kind of clean my hand off a little bit. Make my lips look a little champed. All right. Where's my powder? I need powder. And then, really? Just stuck my finger, I mean my hand, onto my lipstick after I just cleaned my hand off. This is also why you just need toilet paper. This is why I have toilet paper at my beauty station. Okay, so you're gonna do that and then... Usually it gives them that chapped look, I guess. Maybe I need like the gray. It works with the gray, I know it does. So it gives it that more like chapped effect. Mostly because it really does chap them. I'm gonna put some black on them. Yeah, I look chapped now. I put a little bit more of the red. Cancel out the color that I just put on there. And my lips feel gross. I mean, did I really expect them to feel good? No. Okay. And then just because I just kind of messed with it a little bit, I'm going to take this light red lipstick again and kind of just put it back into the cuts. Just to kind of give it that more fresh look. Okay, now. So then, put that right there. I have to move this, sorry, because it's in my way. So this is the finished look. Got some cuts going on. Some flabby skin. Would you go to prom with me? I would. This is how I'm going to look on my wedding day. I'm going to walk with that eye like, boy, you better still think I'm beautiful. Just kidding, I'm not getting married. Anyways, so this is the finished look. I guess I could take my hair down so you guys can see what it's going to look like. Ow! I don't like bobby pins. They hurt my hair. Anyways, like, I hope you guys liked this because I honestly, like, I had an idea, but I didn't honestly know where I was going with it. If you know what I mean. Oh, okay. I was like, where's that other chunk of hair? It was up in the bobby pin still. And it kind of looks really cool. I'm going to wrap my hair up a little bit. If you guys don't know about this, you just take a piece of hair and push up, just so you know, for next time, if you ever want to make your hair look really gross. I can't see my hair, so I have to, like, squat down so you guys can see it. So there we go. Can you tell? Oh, I need to kind of scrunch this one up because it's blocking my beautiful cut on the side of my face. Do something with it. The hair in the way. Alright, so there's my beautiful final look. I hope you guys all enjoy it. Bye guys.